Hi, and welcome to the fourth part of our simple character controller series. You should, by now, have a character that's both moving and rotating. But, as you may or may not have noticed, our character is completely ignoring gravity. Let's move our character on top of a platform here, just a basic cube. Playing now, you can see that the character is floating and not being dragged down by gravity if you leave the platform. Let's jump back to the player controller script and add a new private variable of type float called gravity with a value of -9.81. I am not one to answer where the value 9.81 comes from, but simply put, that's the default gravity on Earth. Depending on the game you're making, however, this value might have to be modified, since realistic physics don't always translate to a fun game. What we should do, instead of directly modifying the gravity value, is to add a multiplier. So let's do that. Add a serialized private variable of type float called gravity multiplier with a default value of 3. We'll also add yet another private variable of type float called velocity. Let's start off by cleaning up our script a bit. This is just to make it easier for us to manage the code later on. Below our update method, add a new private method called applyRotation. Copy everything from our if statement here down to here where we set the rotation and paste it in the new applyRotation method. Now, before moving our character, let's call applyRotation. Add another private method called applyMovement. Copy and paste the move function from the update method into the applyMovement method and call it after applyRotation. Now, add yet another one called applyGravity. Start by typing velocity plus equals gravity multiplied by gravity multiplier multiplied by time.deltaTime. Now we can just modify the y-axis in our direction variable by setting it to velocity. Direction.y equals velocity. Before calling applyRotation, let's call our new applyGravity function and jump back into Unity. I'll just quickly add a tiny ramp for us to get up and down to try this out. You can see that the player does drop down to the ground if we move away from our cube. But, looking closely, you can see the player almost snapping to the floor. Let's look at the velocity value under debug here in the inspector. The problem, as we can see here, is that we keep on pushing the velocity value without it ever being reset. Unless we're in the air, we shouldn't have to modify the velocity value. So, let's jump back into our player controller script and take care of this. What we need to do first is to check if our player is grounded. Luckily, there's a built-in function for this called isGrounded. So, in our applyGravity method, type if characterController.isGrounded. We will just set the velocity to say -1. And else, we will just copy and paste this part here. A value of 0 might work for you here, but I have gotten better results with a value of -1. Something else we can do is here, check if character controller is grounded, and, with 2 ampersands, velocity is less than 0. Let's jump back into Unity to try this out. Isn't this just looking a lot better already? Looking at the debug, we can now see that our velocity value stays at -1 as long as the player is grounded. And that's it for adding gravity to your character controller. If anything is unclear, or if you have any other questions or requests, just let me know. This project is now updated on GitHub, and as usual, the link is down in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.